Next up, we are going to talk about bar plots and count plots. These graphs, rather than giving up information about the distribution of data, they give the information about central tendency. Okay, so let's first focus upon bar plot and let's see what it offers. So let's say we want to find out what is the mean value of tip for smokers and non-smokers. This is the information that we want. So basically we want an information of a numerical data with respect to a categorical data. So here is what we will do. We'll write SNS dot cat plot, our figure level function, and then we'll pass X is equal to the value, which is smoker column. Then Y will be equal to tip. Kind parameter will be set to bar, and at the last we'll just write the name of our data frame, and let's run this code. And this is the code. Somehow both have a mean of 3. In fact, let's do one thing. Instead of tip, let's try total bill. And yeah, so average total bill for smokers is a little higher than the average smoker, average non-smoker's bill. Okay, so this is the information that we get from a bar plot. Now you must be wondering, what are these black colored bars? These bars are known as error bars, and they are actually showing the confidence interval to calculate mean for the population. Okay, so you'll have to first study confidence intervals in order to understand what these error bars are signifying. But in short, I can tell you that this plot is trying to infer the value of mean for the population with a confidence interval of 95%. Okay, if I run this shift tab, I can show you the default value of CI is 95. So there is a 95% confidence that the mean of the population will lie in this given range. Okay, so this is what it signifies. Now, as we were constantly doing in other plots, we can also use a hue parameter over here. So let me show you. I can write SNS dot cat plot. You can also use bar plot, your choice. X is equal to smoker, Y is equal to total bill. Let's take the hue parameter to be equal to sex, and kind will be bar, and the data would be tips. And now if I run the code, you can see I'm getting the same information across categories of gender. Okay, one more thing that I would like to talk about is that the default value or the default behavior of bar plot is to calculate the mean of the numerical value, but you can actually tweak this feature using a small setting called estimator. So there is a parameter which is optional, and if I can again show you, just one second. Yeah, so the estimator is basically a function which calculates mean. Okay, so this is basically the location of the mean function in the memory. Okay, but if you want, you can actually change it to something else. Let's say if I want to find out the median, so I will write estimator equals to np dot median. Just remember, you have to provide the name of the function. You don't have to call it. Okay, you just have to provide the name. So shift enter, and here it is. Now this time around, we are getting the median values for the total. You can also change it to let's say var, as in for variance, it will work. Or you can change it to std, as in standard deviation. So you can play around with different functions, and most likely it will work according to your requirement. Okay, so that was bar plots. Now let's move on to count plots. So count plots are basically a special case of bar plot, where you actually do not consider any numerical value. You just take a categorical value and you find the count of that value. Okay, it's very similar to histograms. The way histograms work on numerical data, count plot does the same thing on categorical data. Let me show you. What if I want to find out the number of males and females in our given data. So here is what I'll do. I'll write SNS dot catplot. I'll just provide the X, which is going to be 6. I'll provide the kind, which would be count. And finally, just provide the data, which is tips. And this is a count plot. Simple, right? So on the X axis, we have the categories. On the Y axis, it's giving me the count. Okay, so it's very, very simple. You can also add a hue parameter if you want. So if you want to find out how many females are smoker, how many men are non-smoker, just pass the smoker column as hue. And here's the values. Here are the values. So using this graph, you can easily interpret the count of, you know, things. So that was it for the video. I hope it was clear. In the next video, we'll discuss point plots. Thanks for watching.